What's up, everybody? I'm back. I'm motherfucking back. So, let me apologize for last week, because I know y'all were looking around like, where the fuck is T-Spillin' at? Now, y'all real had 24-hour duty and shit, you know, that shit happened, right? And y'all real is all over the fucking place. Like, this simple head motherfucker forgot to even record the shit with the comments and shit. So y'all see what happened when I let him. But he didn't want me to come out of play last week. That's okay. But I'm here this week. And don't be hating. Chuck your fence, don't be hating. But how are we all doing today? Hello, everybody, on this blessed Sunday. Hello. Now, welcome to us talking about tabloids. Well, for those of y'all who don't know what the hashtag stands for. Are you cooking and watching? Okay, all right. No, just don't be just I don't want you to burn your food up fucking around with me today. Okay. But for those of y'all who do not know, this is tabloids and trending topics. All right, so we're gonna talk about what's in the tabloids, what has been trending. We're gonna discuss it while sipping on some tea. Now, this right here is a cola dense tea because I ain't having enough time to go get, you know, my other shit, but that's okay. Like I said, I still got the base in there, so we good. We good. Yes, Chucky Fenster, yes, channeling Mr. Chucky, yes, glory. So, we gonna sit here, we gonna talk about some shit, and this right here is the Creep Edition. If you are asking, why is this the Creep Edition? Because motherfuckers been creeping this week, so we gonna talk about some creeps and shit, okay? But, as you all know, since this is how y'all real has structured this, we're gonna talk about the heavy shit first. So we're going to go ahead and talk about the prayers. Well, thank you for making it. Okay, I'm Emma. Okay, I've also been called Chucky Fenster, so I'm a channel Elmo too. Tickle me. If you can. All right, so first, rest in peace to Five Dog. He was part of a tribe called Quez. He died at 45 this week. He had a struggle with diabetes, and he had also had a liver transplant. And like I said, he was a fairly healthy dude, but that kind of goes to show that, because a lot of times we equate somebody having diabetes with being a big person, which is not always the case. And for those of y'all who watched the Love & Hip Hop reunion, apparently salt gives you diabetes, but that ain't none of my beer. Sesame Street actor David, I believe his last name is Schmurl. He was Mr. Hanford. He passed away at the age of 80. He had lung cancer. So prayers to his family. Gary Shandling passed away at age 66. He was a comedian. And we don't know what the cause is just yet, but it was said that the day before, I guess he was talking about having chest pains, and then he had passed away. And former Toronto Mayor Rob Ford died at age 46 of a rare form of cancer, but they did not say what it was. Yes, a lot of people passed away this weekend. So as we're moving throughout our day on this blessed Sunday, let's, you know, at least try to keep them in our prayers. And also, before I forget, to all those who celebrated, happy Easter to all of you. I'm probably the only person on here that celebrates it, but Purim was Thursday night to Friday night. Let's just say Yarrell had a good time and he was incapacitated and immobile on Friday. Okay. So, no disrespect to the dead. Now that we got that shit out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about the fuck shit. Okay, let's talk about the fuck shit. Now, before we talk about the fuck shit, I need for y'all to keep in mind. Hey, Red, how you doing, babe? Keep in mind, I want y'all to think about who get the L of the week and who gonna get the W. Who gonna be loser of the week, who gonna be winner of the week. I need y'all to keep that in mind as we go through these topics. And y'all, I got some topics. So we gonna be here for a minute. I gotta make up for y'all Real's lackluster performance last week because he disappointed. He has some good topics too and fucked the whole shit up. I tell y'all about that simple motherfucker. And right quick, if y'all don't know, Yarrell just did two music video reactions and reviews, and he beat me to it. He did one for BBOD's Hell of a Night and for Mariah Lynn's Money Gun. He was going to do them tomorrow because the reunion part two for Love of Hip Hop airs tomorrow, but I kind of encouraged him to get it done today. So check those out when we're done here. But Matt Barnes, it's all about this simple-minded light skin and his feelings, motherfucker. So last week, got to see that craziness. Actually, and before I talk about this right quick, we did get flagged because actually a dispute was filed on the BBOD video because of using their images. So we've had to fight that because it all falls under. Oh, I got the vape, baby. It all falls under the whole fair use. So we're fighting that right now. Hopefully the same shit doesn't happen with the Mariah Lynn video, but if it does, we will fight that shit too. Okay. But we all talked, well, Yarrell spoke last week about how Matt Barnes chased, I believe it was a John Henson, down the tunnel. And I guess that tunnel led to the locker room and whatnot. And I believe they both were ejected from the game. Well, his punishment has, be nice. His punishment, well, not really. His punishment was actually, well, he received his punishment this week. And he's going to go one game without pay. So this suspension is going to cost him $32,000, which pushes his total, I guess, violations, or I'm sorry, fines of the year to $1,000 or over $1,000. So all the fines he has received this year are totaling upwards of $1,000. Now, motherfucker, we at the end of March. So you mean in 3 months you done racked up $100,000? I got his penis to him. Damn it, shit, $100,000. So you and your feelings that merch that you done already racked up $100,000 for 2016, and we at the end of March. So either it's him or maybe that Govan pussy. Got these motherfuckers acting all types of crazy. We got this motherfucker running through tunnels and shit. We seeing, is it Gloria? No, Laura on fucking damn the next 15. You know, her husband is sitting here chaining up doors and shit, locking people out and shit, doing all types of crazy shit and shit. What the fuck? Okay, maybe, you know what? Maybe they pussies are cursed. I think that's what the fuck it is. Okay, men, stay away from them Govans. Govans, stay away. Stay away. That's forbidden fruit right here. Stay away. That shit is cursed. Shit is cursed. But how the fuck y'all feel about that? Cause I feel some kind of way, which is like, really, we this damn emotional that we chasing motherfuckers down tubes and shit. We this damn emotional that we sitting here losing $100,000. Do you know what, motherfucker? Do y'all know what I can do with $100,000? Okay. Shit. Bullshit. Bullshit. Okay. Okay. Woo! So, moving on. Let's go ahead and talk. Now, first let me say, if y'all do not know, Yarrell does not do sports. Yarrell hates sports with a fucking fervent passion. Hates it. This is going to be one of the few times that, like, sports will truly be, like, a highlight of this fucking segment on any fucking segment that he does. So we've already talked about one fucking sports player. Let's talk about Dwight Howard. So he plays for the Houston Rockets. He got caught using an illegal substance on his hands during a basketball game. Now this substance is called Stickum, and it's also been used in the NFL. Now this substance is banned in the NBA. I don't know if it's necessarily banned in the NFL. But when you put this on your hands, it helps the ball to stick to your hands a little bit more. And what happened is, I guess he passed the ball off to someone several times, and that person just refused, I guess, to do anything with it. I don't know. I wasn't watching it. I wasn't there. But complained about having a sticky substance on it. And he has said that, I don't see what the big deal is. I've been using this for you know, I guess, like the whole time. And with him saying that, okay, you admitted this to doing it for some time, and says this is an illegal substance by the NBA. Don't know what's going to happen to pimping. But Pimpin' got something coming, so either it's gonna be a fine or Pimpin' probably not gonna be playing for the Houston Rockets because he wants to. Now here, now he wasn't ingesting any legal substances, but had it on his hands, and of course, for what it's worth, that can cause an unfair advantage. So, how do y'all feel about that? Me personally, I don't think that my career is worth it. And if you are that skilled of a basketball player, you shouldn't need anything like that. But putting yourself in a very uncompromising position is not smart in any way, shape, or form. Any way, shape, or form. Especially when you got motherfuckers tricking on your ass. Now, I'm trying to figure out, okay, how the fuck? Ain't nobody said shit this entire time. And then, you know, the tea was spilled, you know. I mean, you know, I keeps my cup ready. Tea was spilled that this motherfucker, you know, came on talking about how, you know, much of a Christian he was in the very beginning. But this motherfucker is you know, busting them down, having children out of wedlock and shit. Even was playing around with some little children and shit. It was even, you know, people even saying maybe that sticky substance was, you know, some, but I don't know. I don't know. But I ain't one of the gossip, so you ain't heard that from me. Moving on to the next topic. So last week, Yareel spoke about Michael Jackson's catalog and how that was probably the dumbest fucking move his estate made. And to my understanding, 50% of, I guess, the shares that he had of that is going to Sony and is being sold for 750 million. So as of right now, this is no longer alleged. This is actually real shit. And Yarrell with his dumb ass and forgot who the fuck the motherfucker was, but was asking who his best friend was that was part of the Beatles and shit. And it was Paul McCartney. Now, if you guys remember, Paul McCartney and Michael Jackson used to be good friends, and when he bought their catalog, Paul thought, okay, you go do me a solid and slide that shit this way. Hell to the no, hell to no. It's pretty much what Michael Jackson said. Michael Jackson kept this shit. Well, his estate. What you can do? Man. My whole thing is if you finna sell the catalog 750 mil, you should have sold that shit for more. Because of what can be made off of that and the whole sampling business, like, come on, come on. But Paul McCartney was pissed about it, that ruined that fucking friendship. Now, I had even said, and I believe y'all real said last week, not sure, Paul McCartney would be a fool to not try to sit him and try to come for the, like, the, well, I guess the royalties of the rights to the Beatles music. Well, it has been said that he has already begun this process, starting all the way back in December. So, it's one of those things where it's just like, you know what? To the estate of Michael Jackson, y'all stupid. And y'all finna let Paul get his hands back on that motherfucking money. So my question is, was it worth it? Was it worth it? Okay. Now, this is when I need to kind of. Now, I'm admit to y'all, I don't have my notes in chronological order. Because I was taking the notes and put the notes in and shit. So not everything is in order, but that's all right. We just gonna sit here and talk some shit and shit. But I need to grab one more. I need to grab two pieces of notes and put them together. Okay, so y'all give me just a second. And I know y'all probably saying this is fucking not professional. I know. I know. But shit happens. All right, now that I got my notes together. Cause I we gonna talk about some Real Households of Atlanta. If I'm not mistaken, I think part two of the reunion airs tonight. I hope so. I hope so. Off the stove. And I cannot wait because, you know, I really want it to air tonight. Before I continue, a subscriber had asked y'all real if he would get on Blab at some point and kind of talk about these reunions. And what's going to happen is I don't know if it's going to be y'all real, one of the five of us, you guys should keep just keep stay tuned. Y'all will get a video real soon about the rest of his personalities, to include me and the four others. But Yarela is in the process of working on getting a couple other YouTubers together, and once the next 15 reunion is complete and everybody has done their reviews, Yarela alongside of some other YouTubers are going to come together, and they're going to talk about the Love of Hip Hop New York reunion and the show in its entirety, the Real Households of Atlanta reunion and everything in its entirety, and the next 15. So that right there should be interesting, and I think y'all already know that it's going to start there, and where it goes from there, we don't know. But back to the Real Households of Atlanta. It has been reported, and fuck reported, Kim Fields ain't returning on the next one. Now, I would get out of my seat, but shit kind of crowded, so throw my hands up and shout. Hey. All right. Small little praise break on this Sunday. I had to shout right quick in place because, you know, like I said, I got too much going on right now, so I couldn't get out of my seat, but I had to shout in place right quick. Shout in place right quick. She ain't returning. And she has said on the Ricky Smiley Morning Show that her mom told her to get in and get out. So she won and done. So she pretty much treated this shit like a one-night stand. So Kim Fields, thank you. You were not really fucking needed. Appreciate you. And go ahead, twirl your ass on Dancing with the Stars. And I wish you the best of luck. Okay, best of luck. Possibly. It was very strategic of her, and I mean, I will say that she carried herself very nicely. Now, I think Chris should stay on the show. Oh, she was fine. Well, let her tell it. She's off the show. And, you know, I mean, it is what it is, but I don't know who said it. But another YouTuber has said that Vivica Fox should come on to the Real Housewives of Atlanta because she already does not like Kenya. So right there, it is what it is. Okay. Are you ready on a couple of sites? Oh, okay. All right. We'll come on through fact checking. Okay. Mm-hmm. But it is what it is. She's no longer on the show. And no hurt feelings. Now, I think we all agree that this shit deserves a motherfucking recast and shit. Okay. And I chose to not talk about a lot of shit. Okay. This is not Derek J. I'm giving y'all Mary J. Blige, Family Affair, No More Drama mixed with Chucky Fester off Rugrats mixed with Elmo, Tickle Me Elmo. That's what I'm giving y'all right now. Okay. It's like I say, here's the thing. Having fun, don't give a fuck who the fuck sees. We having fun over her, okay? We having fun over her. If y'all ain't here to have fun, then y'all go ahead and find somebody else to scope in right now. Okay. But anyway. So we're done with that. Let's go ahead and move on to someone else who is not going to be returning to the Real Households of Atlanta. Now, I'm not going to talk about Cynthia, I lost my spine again, Bailey. We're not going to talk about her. Okay. Yeah. But Patricia has quit the Real Households of Atlanta. Now, he has said that. Oh, you know what? Here's the thing. Let's get Vivica and what the girl name is, New York. Put their asses on the Real Households of Atlanta. I'm telling you, I will be all types of fucking through, all types of through, and this shit is getting in my eyes right now. I would be here for it. I would watch her fucking episode. You ain't gotta fucking live in Atlanta. Here's the thing: she can sit here and have a rental in Atlanta and be in Atlanta for the fucking shoot, and then take her ass back to where the fuck she at. But I would love to see it. I heard Stacey was being considered too, and she need to, here's the thing, she need to be considered, you know, that was too easy, just like that hoe, Y'all about to make me go there. About to make me go there. But I ain't gonna do it. But Patricia was saying that Real Housewives of Atlanta destroys marriages. It does not help build the marriages up. And because his marriage has reached a good point on the show, he wants to end on a good point. Ooh, no, you did it. Don't bring the chateau in this now. Not the chateau. But his whole thing is his marriage is at a good point right now, and where the show has left his marriage off, he wants to end at a good point. That's cute, but we know Horsha got some shit to say about his relationship. So we gonna see how this all plays out, okay? And it was also even rumored also that Kim Sosiak will be returning to the households. Now, unless they try and do some, you know, old clique versus new motherfuckers, I don't know what they trying to do. I'm gonna have to ask them to get this shit together, okay? Okay. Yeah, separate, but and I just don't know what they're going after, and you know, it is what it is. You be here for Kim. I stopped seeing it for Kim a long time ago. I stopped seeing it for that half a long ass time ago. Okay. Are you like him? Okay, all right. Here's the thing. Let's be clear. Kim was an honest hoe. Now, here's the thing. Y'all know how I feel about honest hoes and honest whores. She was an honest hoe. Okay. She was honest about what the fuck she did. Okay. She was very fucking honest. She let y'all know that I'll bust this pussy wide open. Okay. Okay. Hey, bust that shit wide open. Spread it wide. She was honest about her shit. See, I wasn't gonna bring Crow into this. I was gonna leave Crow alone now. I was gonna leave Crow out of here. But at the same exact time, I didn't like him now, and this is a mixture of shit. Before I make my statement, someone can only treat you the way that you allowed them to treat you. With that being said, I did not like how she treated her assistant. I forget the girl name. Y'all let me know. What was her assistant name? I forget. The black girl. What her name was? Cause I know y'all know. Sweetie, there it was. I didn't like how she did Sweetie. I did not like how she talked to it and how she did her, okay? At the same exact time, Sweetie accepted what the fuck happened. So it is what it is. I don't agree with how she talked to her. It's no different than now. Guilty confession, I just got caught up on the haves and the have notes. And James, I done watched your damn reviews and you had my ass sniggling and giggling and shit. But the way that Catherine was coming at Hannah about paying her what she owed, talking about some, you get paid on the first, so either you gonna leave or you gonna work. That's kind of what Kim gave me when it came to Sweetie. And I didn't like that. I didn't like it. And I understand that sometimes you gotta, because we all have, a lot of us have jobs. Many of us don't have careers. A lot of us have jobs. So we understand that sometimes we have to suck up a lot of shit for the sake of keeping our jobs. I understand that. I think we all understand that. But there is a certain level of disrespect that I ain't gonna fucking take now. Yup, slave drop. Yup, Ball head of Snapchat. So that's why I don't see it for Kim. I don't. I don't. I mean, yeah, you on a show with all black women, but come on now. But since we're talking about those that were old, gone, long, and forgotten, let's talk about Lanithia Gonzo Nose Leaks. Lanithia looking like a motherfucking Muppet. Gonzo Leaks. Okay. Now, I like the haves and have nots too. Now, I need for Jeffrey to boss the fuck up. Like, your mama is fucking, Damn it, what's his mom? I can't think of his mama name right now. Y'all know his mama name. Damn it, that's your motherfucking mama. Damn it, okay. Okay, you need to boss the fuck up. Stop acting like David. Act like your motherfucking mama and shit. Veronica, yeah, that is. Like, boss the fuck up. Act like Veronica, shit. Chicago on that ass. Boston. Now, granted, that was moment. We gonna tag you right quick. We gonna have to talk about the haves and the have-nots in some perk, but boss the fuck up, nigga. Boss the fuck up. Like, you, like, there were moments that he bossed up. I got you. Jeffrey got it in him. And again, she's Chicago. She got Chicago in her. Okay, so he has Chicago in him. And he picks and chooses when he wants to boss the fuck up. Okay. Yes, Veronica is a crazy hoe, but she that hoe that you love to hate. Okay. Like, you love her, but you hate her at the same exact motherfucking time. The bitch is cunning, but I love her. What I'm saying is, Jeffrey need to boss the fuck up. Right, motherfucker. Quick. Okay, we didn't get off topic. Back to the households of Atlanta, because we didn't get all the way off topic. If you don't stop, James, stop. Now, Lanithia Leaks, the original household of Atlanta. She could be coming back next season with a significant pay raise. Supposedly, she could be coming back to the Real Households of Atlanta for $2.5 million. I don't know how I feel about that. Yeah, 2.5. Fat pockets, baby. Them pockets, fat baby. I don't know how I feel about that. Only because she ain't really brought shit. And Lanithia, and I'm going to say this, even though I don't see it for that hoe either. I don't see it for her. But she had that perk where she is working on her career. And she's not going to do anything that is going to jeopardize that check. She ain't gonna do nothing to jeopardize that check now. Okay, I hope y'all follow me. So I don't know if she gonna necessarily cut the coon for that 2.5. Don't do that. Don't, Lord. We off the haves and have notes now. Okay, we off the have and have notes. But that's all I had to say about Miss Lanithia. She might be coming back. And she might have a fucking significant pay raise on y'all asses. Okay. Now. Be nice. Not really. Just go the fuck in. But I'm trying to be a little PG. Low key. Did it get hot in her or did it get hot over there where you at? Because now I'm hot. Because I got three fucking, you know, lights on, but not to mention the room lights and shit. And I got this this hot-ass cosplay coif on my head. Coof, whatever the fuck y'all want to call it. So I know I'm hot. Not for the reason your ass is hot. Into it. So, back in sports news. You have two gentlemen, one named Nick Young and the other one named Jordan Clarkson, okay? It's all in my eyes. I'm trying to read and shit. Now, they are on the LA Lakers team. They are getting hit up for sexual harassment. Now, there's this woman named Alexis Jones. This bitch, and y'all gonna follow me when I say this, this bitch happens to be an activist committed to stopping athletes from committing sexual harassment, sexual abuse, and domestic violence. I need for y'all to follow me. Y'all follow me because I'm going to bless you. Now, supposedly, Nick and Jordan pulled up on, I guess on the side of her and her mom in the curb. And Apparently, allegedly, they were making vulgar statements and gestures. Now, this bitch went to her damn IG and posted a picture of them because she didn't know who they were. Now, I'ma show y'all, I'ma zoom in on the pic that she posted. And we're gonna have a small little story time because I'ma read what she said. Okay, so these are the pictures. Now this what this hoe put under it. I'ma read for a minute. Story time. I pray these pics go viral. Bitch, you posted this shit on motherfucking Instagram. Bitch, as soon as you hit that motherfucking button for the shit to fucking upload, bitch, the shit already went viral. The fuck you talking about? But I'm gonna keep reading. This is the problem with little boys. What the fuck is the problem with little motherfucking girls and shit? But we gonna keep reading. We gonna keep fucking reading. 5 minutes ago at the intersection of Melrose and La Brea, I don't know the fuck that's at, but here in LA, a G with four boys pulled up at a red light and start yelling and making the most disgusting vulgar gestures at my mom and me. I rarely rant about things, but this is fucking with all type of, you know, exclamation point, parentheses and shit. Okay, problem. And the reason I've now dedicated my life to educating young men about respect. Okay. Not just for women, but for everyone. I'm angry. I'm insulted. I'm hurt. They were laughing hysterically until they realized I was filming them. And immediately they panicked like the cowards they are. So you filmed it. Keep that shit in mind because we're going to talk about that because you filmed it, bitch. Because you filmed it. But I digress. We're going to come back to it. We're going to come back to it. Thank you to all the real men out there who would never treat a mother and a daughter like this. I'm glad she said them, Tyler, because I wish she would have said treat a woman like this because you ain't acting like one right now. Speaking of, I love for this to make it back to their mothers. Bitch, you think it ain't? Cause she's trying to front like she don't know. Now I don't know who the fuck they is. I know now, but cause I don't do sports. But if you have committed yourself, I'm getting ahead of myself. Hold that. Hold on. I'm gonna get to it. Help me find who these guys are. I got a fan. Can y'all hear the fan? Can you hear it? I got the fan blowing on me cause it is hot on him. Can y'all hear the fan? Oh, okay, but it's now it ain't close to where y'all getting all it. Yeah, it's blurred. Okay, help me find who these guys are. Let's see the power of social media and hold them accountable. I love to have candid conversations with them about sexual harassment. Not simply to shame them, so she's admitting she wants to shame them. But to understand their mentality so we can better educate young men to be respectful in the future. Hashtag, hold on. Oh, it is, but we gonna get there. Oh, we gonna get there. Hashtag little boys, hashtag cows, hashtag real men respect women. Hashtag mess with the wrong chick, hashtag we will find you. Now, here's my whole thing right now. You don't know who these motherfuckers is. And I'm being ghetto. You don't know who the fuck these motherfuckers is. You done took a picture. Because you hoping this shit go viral. Bitch, you put this shit on IG. Apparently, you have a fucking following. But you don't know who the fuck these motherfuckers is. Now, she said she filmed this shit. Bitch, where's the motherfucking video? Because I want to know what the fuck they done said. I want to know what the fuck they done said. Because I don't believe your ass. And then you want to put the shit on IG. Bitch, you ain't get a picture of the motherfucking license plate. You ain't call that shit into the motherfucking police. But we putting this shit on motherfucking IG. You want to sit here talking about a grown motherfucking woman, but you want to sit here and you want to fuck over the lives of two motherfucking men. Because here's the thing, the NBA is currently looking into this shit. Right now. But you don't know who the fuck they is. So, random ass motherfuckers. So these some random ass motherfuckers. And you want the intranet to sit here and tell you who the fuck these random ass motherfuckers. Bitch, is you stupid? Do you think we stupid? I ain't stupid. This bitch that got me and everybody on here watching me right now is fuck smooth the way the fuck up. Y'all know I got high blood pressure. Hold the fuck on. I gotta calm down. Y'all know I got high blood pressure. That shit made me mad. That shit done pissed me off. I wouldn't doubt it. But she trying to act like she don't know who the fuck they were. Because if they really, first and foremost, gestures and saying shit, and you try to sit and destroy their asses, I'm not saying that they didn't do it. But if it was that big of a deal, you ain't call a popo. I'ma calm down. I'ma calm down. Okay. So I'ma let y'all talk about this for a second so I can bring myself back down. But when I say that shit then piss me smooth the fuck off. It made me mad. Because that destroyed that, like, that defies all fucking logic. Not to mention, she has over 1,500 likes and almost 7,000 fucking comments. But you ain't know who the fuck they was. All right. So let's go ahead and talk about me. I am cause it's wrong. It's wrong. Okay, I'm burning bright. Okay, I'm shining bright like a diamond. Rihanna, loud hair tease. Okay, shine bright. Shine. Actually, she had red hair, but they ain't perp. They ain't the perp. All right. Let's go ahead and talk about what all y'all came here to talk about, because I know y'all came here to talk about it. Cat motherfucking Williams. I'ma give y'all the better. Cause I ain't take no notes. Okay. We just gonna talk about it. First and foremost, y'all know that I am not talking about a lot of shit in reference to Cat Williams for a reason. Like, even though I sit here and I just got done calling this Alexis whole bitch and shit, I try my best not to tear down a lot of our people, especially somebody that is going through some shit. Now, we all know. Yeah, no jokes. We gotta pray for him. We gotta pray for the brother. Now we all know what happened. Okay, we all know. We all are aware to the upper room. But we all know that the first video aired or was released, and so many people jumped on it. I try not to just jump on shit, and if I do, like, had the first video came out today and I talked about it, I would truly say based off what I saw. Okay. But when the shit finally came out, but this is one of those where, you know, keeping it real went all the way to fuck wrong. Now, I commend and I applaud. He going through. He really is going through. He going through. I applaud Cat Williams for trying to be, you know, outstanding. Because there are a lot of celebrities that go back to the hood. There are a lot of them. A lot. Oh, I understand, like, because here's the thing, like, I'm not finna tear the man down. I'm not. I'm really not. That's not what I'm here to do. But I understand what keeping it real goes wrong. Like when I go to Chicago, I always go back to the hood because my mother stays in the hood, so I'm always back there. If I get a chance to hang out with some of the people that I grew up with, I do. You feel what I'm saying? And which is what he did. Now, I'm not a celebrity by no fucking means. Now, if I were to be a celebrity, I'm gonna keep it straight up 1,000 with y'all asses. If you think I'm gonna be out there without at least one motherfucker protecting me, whether or not they know that it's security or not, you lost your damn mind. Now, Cat Williams out there playing soccer and shit, but then. I got you. I got you. But he trying to give back. And then you and it's one of those things where it's just like it's the whole crabs in the barrel type mentality. And we can't sit here and just uplift somebody. So you gotta sit here and I know, I know. Like I said, especially with me putting wigs and shit on, I know the next time I go to Chicago it might be some shit, but that's all right. But even with all of that, you feel me? It's just he's trying to do a good thing, and of course, it gotta be some niggas that's gonna sit here and try to test him. And you see that he was trying to walk away. Now, what he fucked up at was engaging this motherfucker. Now, we can't sit here and call Cat Williams no motherfucking punk. I mean, he took that L. He took it, baby. But you let now, granted, everybody trying to say he was in seventh grade and shit, but motherfucker looked 17 and shit, and he got choked the fuck out and shit. Okay. James, stop. But you know, it's one of those where I just don't like it, and it's one of those when motherfuckers come out the hood. And they don't give back. People got the most shit to say about them, but when they try to come back to the hood and try to give back, shit like this happens. You know what I'm saying? It's one of those where we're damned if we do, damned if we don't. And I think we all understand that a lot of black people are programmed in this, where it's nothing but programming, and it's sad. It really is sad that he was trying to sit here and do a good deed, and it's one of those where yeah, he could have walked away. Cat Williams could have also sat here, looked at one of them children, just like, look, I'm gonna sit here and throw your ass $200, whoop his ass for me. But to sit here and get into a fight with a child, even had he won, he still would have been wrong. You know what I'm saying? So, but I'm glad the full footage came out. I'm not gonna say it validated Cat Williams in any way, shape, or form, because in my opinion, he is still somewhat wrong. And I was somewhat hoping that Cat Williams would have laid his punk ass out. Okay, because a lot of these motherfucking kids think we can sit here and talk shit to older motherfuckers like they ain't finna sit here and get knocked the fuck out. I'm just saying. He shouldn't have engaged him. He shouldn't. But I'm a motherfucker where it's just like I will try to. Ooh, shit, y'all. Y'all getting to. Hold on, wait. Let me move that down, cause y'all. Y'all ain't supposed to see. Y'all ain't supposed to see that up there. Despite the fact y'all already know, but that's one of those. Well, you finna sit here and try to whoop his ass. Don't try whoop his ass. Okay. Cause you looking real bad right now. But that's all I'm gonna say. That's all I'm gonna say. Cause we gotta look too real. Y'all know we trying to sit here and laugh and shit. 10 minutes ago. Yeah, the boy didn't. He ain't had nothing to lose. I'm not gonna lie. You right. You're definitely right. But I mean, but at the same exact time, no, we can't sit here and act like if a motherfucking little ass motherfucking bastard getting our motherfucking now. Cause here's the thing on some real shit. I will whoop a kid ass quick, fast, in a motherfucking hurry. I just try my best not to. I don't think it's afraid. I don't think we're afraid to admit that we need help. But I think we've been conditioned to be so strong that we ignore the fact that we can sometimes have chemical imbalances, that we can sometimes suffer from things such as, you know, mental illnesses, suicide, all these other things, you know. But let's go ahead and move on to something else, because we're starting to get a little too serious. And I need to take like a 60-second pause right quick. I'm going to let y'all talk amongst y'allself, because y'all see I've been licking these lips and I done forgot to sit some chapstick over here, so I need to find some chapstick. Give me about 6 seconds. Don't go nowhere, but y'all keep on talking. Hold on. Hold on. Move this out of the way. I couldn't find it, so I'm about to go straight ghetto and hood. I didn't got that Walmart brand Vaseline. Yeah, I want y'all to see it. Ain't no shame, ain't no motherfucking shame round her. Chap lips ain't sexy. Chap, exactly, it worked. Chap lips ain't sexy round her. We gonna keep the shit funky. We're going to keep it motherfucking 1,000 around this. We're going to keep it 1 million in this bitch, okay? No matter how bougie y'all think y'all real and all his personal Walmart brand bitches, that petroleum jelly on that ass. On that ass, okay? Because it's not cold. I mean, hey, it is what it is, okay? We ain't fronting over here. We keeping it real, okay? We keeping it straight real. I don't know if anybody ever said I was bougie, but, you know, again, we just keeping it 1,000 over her. Because, you know, a lot of motherfuckers have y'all real name in their mouths and shit, and they don't know what the fuck they talking about, okay? But it is what it is. So we're going to briefly talk about a person. Now, we're not going to really talk too much about the, you know, so the whole creeping status. But we're going to talk about the boy named, I think his name is Israel Houghton. Okay. Now, this boy named Israel worked for Joel Ministries. And apparently, okay, well, apparently this timeline, Ain't nothing wrong with the dollar brand, okay? Here's that shit. We need to use the dollar brand of rentals too, but we grabbing for something else, baby, okay? Well, I never said you. I never said to you. But anyway, because we get all the way on topic. So this individual is I'm assuming it is either a gospel artist or a musician, more or less. And he was separated, I want to say, give or take, for like the past 5 years, something like that. Just recently got divorced from his wife back in February, announced it on his Facebook, and he didn't up and got caught on the beach and shit with Adrienne Bylurn. This is the cheetah girl. This that hoe from 3LW, the light skinned hoe, the Latin hoe that thought she had the best vocals and shit, cause all she doing is sitting here and that's a motherfucking Tamar shit. I feel you, okay. Looking like, you know, Nessa Tamar shit. But you got Natiri, the bitch they was motherfucking sitting here hating on, sitting here and getting gigs and shit. She on power and shit. She was in fame and shit. Giving your ass vocals and shit. Okay. Because she wasn't a cheetah girl, but she done moved on to Big and Bad Thing. What the fuck your ass doing being extra looking stale on the motherfucking reel and shit? But we not here to talk about her. Oh, she was with that ass too? Yes. Lanho. Okay, wait. James, and I need for everybody to chime in. How many of y'all think that Adrienne Ballon is a hoe? I just narrowed it down to being a Latin hoe, because I don't know if she's Mexican, Cuban, Dominican, Puerto Rico. I don't know what she is, but I just said she was Hispanic hoe. Is that better? How many of y'all think Adrienne Ballon is a hoe? We got hands. We got hands. I want to know who all thinks she a hoe. I need a prop. Okay. Yes, Puerto Rico. I'm giving y'all a little bit of a Mabel tease right now. Madea. So, she a hoe. Okay, you know what? Latin hoe probably was wrong. I'm sorry. Is she admitting that? Hey! Oh, she a Puerto Rico hoe? Okay, Puerto Rico. Okay. All right, and if y'all want to just join me, just want to let y'all know, y'all real has done two music video reviews on Mariah Lynn's Money Gun and BBOD's Hell of a Night. So when we get done, y'all make sure y'all go over to his YouTube channel, Spilling All the Tea, and checks that shit out. Okay, people watching. All right, just had to check on the analytics and shit. But Mr. Israel, is supposedly dating. Supposedly dating her. And it's rumored that she might be the reason that he broke up with his wife. Or what caused the divorce. But from what I understand, I think they were separated for like 5 years. And she just recently broke up with her boyfriend. Which means that if this is all true, they had to have been dating for at least about a year for this to even make sense. And if they were already separated, huh? Now, we all do realize separated does not mean divorce. And I need for Adrian to sit here and learn from what happened with Miss Fantasia Barrino and her motherfucking situation, because old boy was separated and Fantasia got caught the fuck up. And unfortunately, she attempted to commit suicide. Praise be to God that she did not pass away on us. I know James is on here probably praising the Lord right now that Fanny didn't die on us. Because here's the thing. For y'all who don't know, Fantasia, she can sit here and put on a tribute. She can do a tribute for any motherfucking body and take your ass to church, take your ass to glory, and bring your ass back first motherfucking class. Okay? Okay, I'm just saying. So, this and all of that shit came and it hit Fantasia hard in the sun, bitch. Okay? All jokes aside. So, Adrian should learn from that. And then if y'all finna sit here and if y'all, meaning her and Israel, if y'all finna sit here and go public, y'all should have strategically planned this shit out to where it looked like y'all just met each other after the divorce and y'all taking shit slow rather than being a full-blown out relationship. Now, because you did this, Israel, he works with Joel Osteen. Well, Joel Osteen, them. Oh, they go back. Yeah, I feel you. But he diverse now. But Joel Osteen Ministress then sat here and, okay, he's doing indefinite sabbatical right now. Now, whether or not if Joel Osteen Ministries put his ass there or he chose to take it on his own, we don't know. I think that Joel Osteen is saving motherfucking face right now. Well, see, here's the thing. You know, you gotta ask yourself, is it gonna be pussy slash dick or is it gonna be coins? You gotta ask yourself. You gotta ask yourself, is this fucking piece of flesh right here worth my motherfucking coins? And if it is, play that shit smart. But he wasn't that damn smart. And I'm going to say this. Joel Osteen going to sit here and save face like a motherfucker. Because he ain't finna lose money. This mega church motherfucker ain't finna lose no motherfucking money on your ass, okay? That's a new time. Well, he might be fired, baby. He might be fired, fire red, baby. Might be. Might be. All right. I'm about to drink all... let me finish this shit up, because I'm about to drink all my damn tea. And I ain't even done. We ain't even done yet, y'all. We still got some shit to talk about, y'all. So, let's talk about y'all W of last week, which was Miss Ciara. Now, Ciara and Rasael, you know, Ruffle Chips, allegedly... Hey, he's just fucking with his coin now. Allegedly, they are not talking about prenups because they don't want to fuck up their premarital bliss. So, allegedly, it's rumored they might get married without a motherfucking prenup. So, I'm going to hit this vape. Y'all let me know how y'all feel about Ciara and Russell possibly getting married without that prenuptial agreement. Cause I know most of the mothers watching me right now is women's, so y'all let me know. You crazy as hell. I want y'all to give me y'all opinions. Stupid. Mm-hmm. She got that good. Well, I mean, let them tell it. She ain't busted wide open. She hasn't laid it low and spread it wide yet. Allegedly. But ain't nothing wrong with that. Y'all know I've been celibate for 15 years. So I can't sit here and talk shit about Ciara being celibate for what? A year and a half, maybe 2 years? I can't talk shit about that. Because I done been in that boat. So I can't talk shit. I can't talk shit. And, you know, they both got... Yes, 15 years. Yes, it's been a whole 15 years. But oh, it's both. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. Don't James. We not finna sit here and do this with each other. Not right now. Not right now. But this is one of those where, and I understand what a lot of people are in general saying that if you go in with a prenup, it's like you're but she puts it on him, baby. Puts it on him. But it is a long time. I did talk about this on the Vlad with Sean Bradley. It never made the light of day. I might do a tea time talk and I might talk to y'all about it and kind of, you know, give y'all why it is what it is. But, you know, okay, yeah, I'm 29. I'll be 30 at the end of this year. So, you know, I'm young, okay? But, you know, that clock is ticking. But, I will say, a lot of people are saying that if you go over the prenup, you're already destined to be fucked up. And what's up, sis? What's up, baby? Ciara is flexible. I seen Ciara, I don't know what song it was, but she was sitting here giving somebody a motherfucking chair dance. She done grabbed the motherfucking size of shit, got her ass in the face, legs in the air. I was like, you better come through. Oh, hey, Sean, how you doing, baby? I'm about to say, you better come through. You better fuck. I was like, come on now. You cook it. Ain't no wrong with that. Ain't nothing wrong. Okay, cook now. I mean, quick tangent shit. Yesterday, I done made a pound cake. I done made some egg base bread, you know, because I didn't feel it, because it's challah, but I didn't feel like braiding it, so I put it in a pan and shit. And I made some nice little dinner roll type breads and shit. So, oh, you saw that? Yeah, mm-hmm. So, I ate almost like a third of that motherfucking pound cake, y'all. I can't. I should not even be eating that. I mean, I should be eating, but I've been eating the pound cake. I've been treating myself today. I've been treating myself. I mean, I could do a little something in the kitchen. Speaking of which, Lady Nika, I'm speaking on behalf of y'all real right now. This tea spilling. I'm speaking on behalf of y'all real. Don't take this the wrong way, and this is not, you know, being misogynistic and shit, but you need to get your ass in the kitchen with a camera, okay? And you need to sit here and give us a cooking segment. I'ma tell y'all real to keep his mouth off the fucking cake. That right there was some shade built into it and shit. But I'ma tell y'all real to not be eating no naked cake. But that was some good cake now. Okay. Okay. And had y'all real had some cream cheese, it would have been a cream cheese pound cake. Now I will say this cake does not have frosting on it. Okay. Okay. Oh, let help the shade off. You know, well, don't charge to y'all real. Charge to me. Charge to the red-headed stepchild of his personalities. Okay. It ain't good for you, but damn it, it feels good. It feels good. Okay. It feels very good. But I'm going to say this. Regardless of what happens, Sierra, work your magic, boo-boo. Okay. Work your magic. And if you and Russell do get married and the shit don't work out, I know y'all both got some coinage. I don't know who got more coinage. You need to put some of that coinage in a fucking offshore account. If you got more, so if y'all diverse, he ain't getting none of your motherfucking coins. And now Russell, I know you're a God-fearing man, and you've been saving yourself. I've been saving myself for the right bitch, too. But you need to put your money in an offshore account. Because if, and I'm not wishing it, if y'all diverse, if it's mutual, y'all could be good. But she might just throw it in the bag, and she might walk away with them coins. Just so I'm just saying. I'm not saying, but I'm just saying. Okay, so before we get into all of the good ratchet shit, I got a couple more things for us to talk about. Okay, a couple more things. Let's talk about Neo's wife. And I'm gonna say Neo's wife because right now she don't deserve no motherfucking name. She is showing everybody her body snap back body journey because she didn't have a cesarean, whatever section. Okay. Now, the reason I say she don't deserve no motherfucking name is for this reason right here. Now, if y'all go back, I don't know which one it is. Y'all really know which one it is. We really don't give a fuck. But we talked about how she has said that she gonna put her child first. And how she no longer wants to be in the spotlight, but she gonna focus on the child. But you done got your motherfucking ass on fucking the intranet with your motherfucking body that has not snapped back yet, showing off your motherfucking body and your motherfucking journey. Why the fuck you sitting here putting pictures on the motherfucking intranet and shit? You need to be sitting here worried about your motherfucking child. What the fuck you need to be worried about? Because while you saying you don't want to sit here, you don't want no fame, and you to put that shit behind you, it don't fucking look like it. Not to me. Because don't nobody care about your body. Don't nobody care about your shit snapping the fuck. We care about Tiana Taylor snapping the fuck back. Okay. We care about Candy Burris snapping the fuck back. Bitch, who you is? Better yet, because it's going to be up. Ike, why she here, Ike? Why she here? Better yet, Hoppo, who this woman? Because we don't know her. Your only claim to fame is you didn't bust your motherfucking legs wide the fuck open. Monisa did the same shit, but Monisa came up with a motherfucking come up. Yes, who you is? Who are you? She think motherfucking stupid around these motherfucking parts. Ain't nobody stupid. Ain't nobody stupid. Okay. I bet not see Neo's wife motherfucking ass in the motherfucking tablet no motherfucking mo. Okay. I'm telling you, she might get red for other motherfucking filth, dust, and every motherfucking thing else. Might sit here and bear the ass cremation on that ass, okay? Till she do right by motherfucking me. Don't do it. Don't do it. I will talk about her ass every motherfucking trending topics, okay? Hell. Well, I'm glad you'll snap back, babe. I'm glad I snapped back, okay? Ooh, okay. Get the money now. Get the money. Mineta silly for if Mineta can sit here and get her eggs salvaged and be able to sit here and get that billionaire motherfucker to sit here and do a surrogate, she might be lucky. Might be lucky. But let's go ahead and move on, because I can sit here and talk about Neo's simple ass motherfucking wife all day long, but that's not why we her. That's not why we her. I ain't watching that. I'm saying I hope she did. I hope she did. Now, this next topic I'm gonna talk about, I want everybody, don't type yet, but go ahead on your fucking screen and type bitch. I want everybody to have bitch pre-typed. Because what I'm about to say to y'all, y'all finna sit here and say bitch amongst some other shit. For all of the ladies that have children, I'm about to say this. I'm gonna give y'all asses a smooth 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Get y'all fingers. Y'all got 2 minutes now to go in if y'all have not seen this video. When you get done, go to T Spillin's Facebook fan page. He put the video over there. Now, there is a woman. She's a pre-kindergarten teacher. Now, there's a special needs child. This bitch is getting ready to walk into the classroom. The child's sitting right there. She puts her knee in this child's back. And knocks this child on the fucking ground. Stands there, helps the child up, but still stands in the motherfucking door. Right? This shit was caught on camera. And then when the fucking shit came out, when the video popped out, that this bitch did put her knee in the back of a special needs motherfucking child. This happened in Georgia. This bitch conveniently resigned. This simple motherfucking muscle back bitch, tyrannosaurus looking ass, triceratops looking ass bitch, honey boo boo motherfucking mama June looking ass bitch, they put her motherfucking knee in the back of a little ass motherfucking kid. This is pre-kindergarten. This bitch sat here and put her knee in the back of this little ass kid. Knocked his ass on the ground. And then when your motherfucking pussy get aired the fuck out, you conveniently resign. Conveniently fucking resign. I can't. You saw that video? Okay. See, I know people who have special needs children, and they are precious. I would have called, had I been there, I would have called a case, because I would have cold-clocked that bitch. Cold-clocked that bitch. Okay. I'm just like, they fuck a, you, here's the thing, because we didn't talk about capital punishment. Fuck a lethal injection. I'm that they better not ever make my ass president, because I will make an example of this bitch. I would be like, oh, it was your knee that fucking did. I would have them chop that out, or if this is the knee right above the mother, yeah, that's an Apple Watch, y'all. Everything Apple. I would have them cut right above the motherfucking knee. And then I will have them burn the motherfucking wound shut. I'll be damned if I let your ass continue to walk around with the same motherfucking knee that you just sat here and knocked this motherfucking kid over with. I wish the fuck you would. I wish the fuck you would. Not today. Not the fuck today. Shit. And for all the women on here and even the men that got kids, 2 minutes. Y'all let me know how the fuck y'all feel, because that shit, I'ma stop. I'ma let y'all talk. I'ma let y'all talk. I'm raising my blood pressure again. Oh, she ain't ready for a west or a south side ass. She ain't ready. She is not, and she did it with the right fucking one because the child was Caucasian and she was Caucasian. She did it with the right motherfucking one. I'm just saying. You would have watched that ass earlier? Shit, baby. Baby. He all t okay. Well, see, I have a friend. His son, well, his stepson, but it's still his son, is special needs, and I swear I love him. He has the most gentle fucking spirit. And I will whoop somebody ass over him. Oh, disappear real quick. I will whoop somebody ass over him. Okay. With that being said, it's one of those where it's just like, I understand. Fucked up on sight. I know the Bible says, you know, you don't fuck with the poor, the widow, or the orphan. Enough said. You don't fuck with the orphan, the widow, or the poor. They should have also said the handicapped, but again, the Bible's written in a different motherfucking time. But I'm telling you, I'm tell shit. They let the bitch. I really hope and pray that if, first and foremost, if she don't get her judgment here on earth, she gonna have to deal with it when she go on to see the Lord. Okay. But this is one of them where no, you need to get some of that retribution here the fuck on earth. Okay. If y'all have not seen the video, go over to, you know. Well, T Spillins, which is me, go over to my fucking fan page. Check that shit out. Because, no. Okay. I'm okay. I'm gonna give y'all a couple more seconds before we move on to the next thing, okay? Oh, you would have sent her to glory. Okay. And here's the thing, she did not hurt the child. Let me say she did not hurt. Well, I can't say if she did or she didn't. But still, that's some shit you don't do. Oh, you was gonna take her to the king? Alright. She ain't had much to bring, but that bullshit she did was her offering, but ain't none of my business. Okay, we gonna move on. Now, this video is the creep edition. So before we talk about the creeps, because the next couple stories coming from her love and hip hop, let's first talk about Nicki. Nicki. I ain't gonna call her Miss Nicki. I don't know. Cause there's only one person that'll get that, and that's Carrie Hilson, Miss Carrie, baby. I'm not gonna call Nicki Miss Nicki nothing, okay? Nothing. But Nicki is booed up with a girl named Rosa Acosta. They booed up. And it is said that this is gonna play out on Love and Hip Hop Hollywood. But by the pictures, she doesn't seem too enthralled. So what I'm getting is this is a fucking storyline. Now, Erica Mena did it best, but I'm looking at fucking, you know, Nicki just like, really? So your plastic ass ain't got shit else but sit here and hook up with somebody, and then the shit ain't even fucking believable. I don't believe you. Miss me with the bullshit. I just want to talk about that right quick. Because the next two motherfucking stories, we finna go from Love and Hip Hop. Actually, we gonna go from Love and Hip Hop New York. No, we didn't just did Love and Hip Hop Hollywood. So we finna go Love and Hip Hop New York. Cause it's wrapping up. Then we gonna touch Love and Hip Hop Atlanta, cause it's about to start up on the 4th. And then we gonna sit here, we'll go into the congratulations. Cause believe it or not, we're almost at the end of this trending topics. Okay. So first, let's talk about Peter. One shot, one kill guns. The motherfucker where his sperm don't never motherfucking miss. Where if this motherfucker nut in your ass, I'm talking to y'all, if he nut in you, Your ass pregnant. You ain't even gotta sit here and speculate. Your ass pregnant. Cause let Tyra tell her she took the motherfucking morning after. His sperm so motherfucking strong. His shit is kryptonite. That motherfucking shit crippled that motherfucking morning after pill, allegedly. 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 So, rumor has it that, you know, yeah, allegedly, Peter Guns is creeping on Amina and Tyra with a random ass bitch. He was not, and I believe it was in Miami, I could be wrong, but not only was he videotaped, he was also photographed by two separate individuals, and the shit was uploaded. So he creeped, yeah, just keep it on the down low, cause nobody's supposed to know. TLC on y'all ass, he was creeping, baby. He want to sit here and say, you know, I'm sorry I'm turning down pictures, but I can't even take a picture without somebody being my motherfucking girlfriend. Nigga, is you serious? Do we look like boo-boo the fool to your ass? Okay. Apparently we stupid. I am not surprised. Creep squad, baby. Creep motherfucking squad. So I just want to talk about that, but that's not the only one. I just wanted to bring that up, you know, since Tyra decided, because not Tyra, we're going to pretend as if Amina got that abortion. We're going to pretend that Peter Guns did not get his vasectomy yet. We're going to pretend. We're going to pretend a lot of shit right now, okay? We're going to pretend. And then we're going to pretend like he didn't get the vasectomy. To me, and got her ass pregnant. But I'm just saying, okay, Amina, fuck Tums, you dumb, 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 dumb. You dumb as fuck, ho. You dumb. Again, everybody told y'all, all us fucking YouTubers told your ass, you should have took Corey, took your ass back to motherfucking Europe and shit, and lived your damn life. But now you want to sit here and coon for a motherfucking coin. Okay. Okay. Got you looking stupid. Okay. And, you know, Lady Nika, since she on here, baby. Remember when I was in Korea and I hit you up and I told you that it was rumor that both of them hoes was pregnant at the same damn time. You remember that shit? Okay. Stupid. So, let's go ahead and end this with some funny shit, y'all. Now, Waka Flocka Flame. And Tammy. Now, Tammy is coming back to Love & Hip Hop Atlanta by herself. So, no Waka. We might get Miss Deb. Now, Chief Keef, Baby Mama, Slim Danger. These motherfucking names, y'all. put Waka on blast. Now, Tammy went and did an interview. I have yet to see the interview. But she blasted Slim Danger, which, okay, no harm, no foul. But what Tammy fucked up and did, Tammy mentioned his other baby mama. And that was Miss Simone Patton. Mentioned her. Now, Simone released some pics of Waka to a blog. I believe it was his dick pics. I don't know. I didn't see it. I ain't trying to see it. But she leaked it, and I think it was Famalas or some shit like that. Y'all look the shit up. Y'all find it if y'all go looking for it. I don't know. But then she went to her IG and said this shit. Cause this shit good, y'all. I hope. Now, my cup is about empty. My cup is about empty. But I hope. Actually, before I read, how full is y'all cups? Cause we almost done. Are y'all cups full or have y'all cups ran over yet? I wonder. Y'all let me know. Because I try to come on here and I try to entertain y'all the best that I can with the fuck shit that's in the entertainment news and shit. So I just want to know. Okay. But I'm going to sit here and I'm going to read this shit off to y'all because she done went to her motherfucking IG and shit. So, she says this. All right, now. I didn't want to get involved. You got a refill on the, oh, on the Alize. All right, now. I didn't want to get involved in this bullshit until I started. I bet you do. I bet you do. Until I started getting messages that Tammy Rivera, in caps, has spoken. Nika, don't. I'm going to tell that firefighter. Has spoken upon me in her quote unquote interview. But let me clear something up. You do not want me to spill this tea on how you and Waka got into it over me on Christmas Day. You didn't already spill the tea, babe, but we gonna keep going. You were better off keeping my name out of your mouth. How dare you try to say I was messing with Quam? LOL, we can go there if you like with three question marks. But we all know I have had my own shit to deal with. And in parentheses, she says, which you mentioned my miscarriage. That was kind of foul, but I'm going to keep reading. I have been on your side and denied the relations with Waka, but don't try me. And below in the caption, that was a picture. You should have kept my name out your mouth. And then it said, and Charlie's Angel, expose me since you think you can. And then she goes on to say, my intentions were not to argue with Tammy or expose Waka. But has she not mentioned Chief Keef's other baby mama that lives in Arizona, I would not be this angry. But then she proceeded to call me a tranny and mention my miscarriage. So therefore, it's war, bitch. Child, that's so good. That shit was good till last motherfucking drop. Now, with Miss Tammy, whatever, like, her bringing up one baby mama was one thing. But what she fucked up at is she mentioned the other baby mama. And then why you brought up her miscarriage, I have no fucking idea. I might have to go and find this interview if I feel that it deserves my time. But it probably doesn't. But with all of that being said, I'm kind of like, really, Tammy? Now, again, conveniently enough, all this shit comes out and we know that Love and Hip Hop... Atlanta comes on the 4th. With the shit with Peter Guns, we all know that Love & Hip Hop New York, the reunion is currently airing. So a lot of it is a matter of convenience. I'm sitting here like, Tammy, I don't know if you want it. I don't know if you want it, because old girl sitting here looking like she gonna give it to you. And while you talking all this other shit, bitch, didn't you catch a fade by Ms. Joseline Hernandez? Didn't you catch a fade? Did you let your motherfucking guard down and Joseline came and they ain't none of my business. None of my business. I'm going to let that go. This beef is between, I believe her name is Simone Patton, which is one of Chief Keef's baby mamas, and Tammy Rivera, Waka Flocka's, I believe they're married, so wife, his wife. But, this one over, you might want to tread lightly. She might want to. Again, especially when you caught a motherfucking fade on camera. On camera, bitch. And when I say Jocelyn, it came for three holes on camera. Tread lightly. Tread lightly. All right, y'all. So we're going to go ahead and end this. Got 4 congrats to put out. And then that is it. And I really do hope all snatch that ass and that motherfucking, ponytail shit she had in. snatched all that shit. But her, got some congratulations to get out the way, and then we are done on this Sunday. On this Easter Sunday. Well, you can always catch the replay, and this time, because you know y'all real fucked up last week, so I'm here to sit here and repair the damages. This with the comments will be up this time. Again, if you guys have not, when this is over, now you have two YouTubers going to look at, you know, Wiz Khalifa's dick pics and shit. But the rest of y'all, go over to Y'all Real's YouTube channel, Spilling All the Tea, and check out his video reviews on BBOD's Hell of a Night and Mariah Lynn's Money Gun. Y'all want to check that out. But congrats are in order. Rihanna featuring Drake, the song Work has been number one on a Billboard's Top 200 for the fifth week. So congrats to Miss Riri. Congrats to Miss Riri. And if you guys are watching this on YouTube, let's just say I might include a little some in here. All right. Stop. Anyway, T.I. and Tiny has welcomed their baby girl. This is lucky number 7, but we don't know the baby's name because it has been put up. T.I. was not with his wife when the baby was born, but, you know, he sent his well wishes. So, you know. Just want to throw it out there now. Kenya, now if y'all remember last week, Cynthia is going to be on Sharknado 4. Well, Kenya is also going to be on Sharknado 4 alongside of Miss Cynthia Bailey Thomas. So congrats to Miss Kenya Moore. And last, Ziggy Marley and his wife has welcomed their fourth child, a son by the name of Isaiah Sion Robert Nesta, into this world. So congrats to them. Two baby births. Okay. Yep, Sharknado. I believe that is on Sci-Fi. So that is all. We had quite a bit to talk about on this Sunday. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Hopefully you guys got your entire life. If it airs tonight, you guys can expect Yarrell to review The Real Households of Atlanta, The Reunion Part 2, and The Real Households of Potomac. Okay. Be nice, James. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this. I enjoyed coming on and entertaining y'all. I'm having to pick up the slack for y'all real, but you know, he's trying. He going through some shit right now. He trying. So, with all that being said, please rate, comment, subscribe, and share. And we will see all of you next Sunday, same time, same place, just with a different set of motherfucking topics. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Y'all have a blessed Sunday. Happy Easter. All right, y'all.